Hi children, this is Aruna, your maths teacher from our school, Vadasana Metric High Secondary School, Arakkonam. Today we are going to see 8th standard maths. The topic is squares and square roots. Okay, we have learnt about squares, right? So what are squares? So I'll give you an example now, which is the application in our day-to-day life. See, when you are going to buy a dozen of apples, what is the meaning of dozen? Yes, dozen of apple is nothing but 12. And the cost of each apple also 12. How much you are going to pay, children? Yes, how much you are going to pay? You are going to pay, you are going to buy dozen of apples, that is 12 apples, and cost of one apple is also 12 rupees. So how much you are going to pay? You are going to pay 144 rupees. Yes, without calculating, if we know the square values, we can say the cost of the apple is 144, right? How we got this 144? Yes, the dozen of apple is 12 apples. The cost of one apple also what? 12. A number which is multiplied by itself is called the square number. Is it clear? So, we are using squares in our day-to-day life also, right? So, a number which is multiplied by itself is called the square of that number, right? So, here 144 is square of what number? Is the square of 12, right? So, 12 is the square root of 144, children. That is, square root of 144 equal to 12. 144 is the square of 12, and just the reverse of that. 12 is the square root of 144. See, 144 is a perfect square. That's why we can find the square root of that number. Not only for 144, children, we can find the square root for all the numbers like root 1, root 2, root 3, for 1, 2, 3. For all the numbers, we can find the square root. Okay. So, how to find the square roots? We are going to discuss in this session, right? Okay. So, who will use square roots? How we will use square root in our day-to-day life? Yes, engineers and carpenters, mostly they will use square root, children. See, engineers, while they are building the house, if they need to make a steps there, what they will do? Yes, to calculate the length of this, here using this other two sides, they will calculate the length. See how the shape is here? It is like a triangle, is it? Yes, in this triangle here it makes 90 degree. Then what is this triangle? Yes, this triangle is a right angle triangle. So to find this length, we will use Pythagoras theorem. What is Pythagoras theorem? Sum of the square of these two sides is equal to the square of the third side. Is it? That is the Pythagoras theorem, children. Using this, they will find the square root to find the length of this third side. Okay, engineers, they will use square roots in our day-to-day life, as well as carpenters also, they will use square root, children. And to find the square roots, there are three methods I told you. One is repeated subtraction, prime factorization, and long division. So, already we have learned this first two methods, repeated subtraction and prime factorization. Today, we are going to learn about square root using long division method. See, square root of 4761, right? This is the number. How to find the square root of this number? We are going to learn, children. Here, first step, what we are going to do is, we are going to pair the number, that is 4761. We need to pair the number from the unit digit. Okay. So, from here, pair this number, just draw a line up over the number. So, we have paired the numbers, okay? Now, by long division method, where is the divisor here? Yes, for this, we need to find the divisor, children. Usually, for division, there will be a divisor. Using 5 table or 9 table, we'll use to divide, right? But here, we need to form the divisor. So, the divisor should be the square numbers like 1 ones are, 2 twos are. See, the table what we are going to write here is the square table. to use for the long division method. See, first 1 into 1, 1 ones are 1, 2 into 2, 2 twos are 4, 3 threes are 9. Likewise, we are going to write the square tables now. Multiply a number with the same number. 4 fours are 16. 5 into 5. 5 fives are 25. Then 6 six are 36. Next 7 into 7. 7 sevens are what? 49. Next 8 with 8. 8 eights are 64. And 9 nines are 81. Now, using this table only, the first step we are going to solve. See, what is the pair of first number? 47. Right? See, in this table where 47 is there? No, exactly we can't get the 47. Then how we will choose the number? The nearest number. So, the nearest number here is 36 and 49. Can we take 49? No, because it is greater than this 47, right? So, the previous number, which is 6, 6 are 36. So, we are going to write that 6, one of the 6 in the divisor place and one more 6 in the quotient place, children. Is it clear? Now, 6, 6 are what? 6, 6 are 36. The next step, what we are going to do? We are going to subtract this. 7 minus 6. What is 7 minus 6? 1. 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3 also 1. The next step, what we are going to do? We want to take the pair of number. Here we want to take the pair of number in the square root, children. The pair of number is what? 6, 1. Now, in the second step, again, we need to form a new divisor. How to form the new divisor? Yes, first what we want to do is, we need to multiply the quotient by 2, children. So, the quotient is what here? 6. Multiply the 6 with 2. 6 twos are what? 12. Write 12 here. And next to this 12 and next to the 6, we need to take one more new number. So, then by finding the product, we will get this answer. Okay. So, in this last step, the number is, which is in the ones place is 1. See, in this table, it is possible, right? In ones place, there are 2 1 out there. In 1 ones are also, I have 1. And one more is what? 9 nines are 81, the number which ends by 1 year also. So, there are 2 possibility numbers. I can take 1 and 1 here, right? See, if we take 1, what will happen? 121 into 1. What is 121 into 1? The same number will get, right? So, but that is not the answer here. So, the next possible answer is what? 9 nines are. So, we are going to take 9 in this place. That is 1, 2, 9 into 9. Multiply now. What is 9 nines are? 9 nines are 81. 1, 8 is remaining. 9 twos are 18. 18 plus 8. 18 plus 8 is 26. 6 remaining is 2. 9 ones are 9. 9 plus 2. 9 plus 2 is 11. Yes, what is the answer now? 1161. The same answer na. So, we are going to take 9 and 9 in the quotient also. Is it clear? So, 129 into 9 is 1161. So, the remainder is 0 here. Therefore, the square root of 4761 equal to what? The quotient is 69. Is it clear how to find the square root using long division method? The next problem is 33856. We are going to find the square root, right? See, the first problem we have seen with 4 digit number, but here it is a 5 digit number. What I told you, the first step, we need to pair the numbers, right? First write the question. 3 3 8 5 6. Now pair the number. from the unit digit we need to pad the number. So finally there is a one digit number, so keep as it is. And now we are going to find the long division of this number. Okay, see, the first number is what? 3. See, in this table where 3 will be possible? This 3 is nearest to 1 and 4. So we can't take 4 because it is greater than this 3. So what we are going to take? 1. So 1 ones are 1. Now subtract this. 3 minus 1 is 2. Now in the next step we want to take the next pair of number, which is 3, 8. Okay, 2, 3, 8. The next new divisor, how to make the new divisor? Yes, I told you to multiply the quotient by 2 children. Yes, multiply 1 with 2, 1, 2's are 2. Now next to this 2 and in the quotient next to this 1, we want to place the same number. And if you multiply the product, it should be nearest to this 238. Okay, how to frame this? See, we can make a table. 21 into 1 equal to 21. Next, 22 into 2. Find the product of this. 2 2's are 4. Again, 2 2's are 4. Next, 23 into 3. 3 3's are 9. 3 2's are 6. 69. So, till we need to multiply the answer where we are getting nearest to 238. So 24 into 4. 4 4s are 16. 6 remaining is 1. 4 2s are 8. 8 plus 1 is 9. 96. Next 25 into 5. 5 5s are 25. 5 remaining is 2. Again 5 2's are 10. 10 plus 2 is 12. 125. 26 into 6 now. 6 6 are 36. 6 remaining is 3. 6 2's are 12. 12 plus 3 is 15. So we got the product as 156. So the next number also we need to check now. So 27 into 7. What 7 7s are? 49. 9. 4 remaining. 7 2s are 14. 14 plus 4 is 18. So 189. 28 into 8 now. 8 8s are 64. 4 remaining is 6. 8 2s are 16. 16 plus 6 is 22. So we got the answer which is nearest to this 238, right? When we got this answer with multiplying by 8. So take the next number as 8 here and write in the quotient also. 28 into 8 is what? 224. What is it? Remaining here, 8 minus 4 is 4 and 3 minus 2 is 1. In the next step, what we want to do? Again, we want to take the pair of number, that is 5, 6. This is the last step now, children. So, by using the ones digit, we can check the answer also. So, first twice the quotient, frame the new divisor here. 18 is in the quotient. What is 18 twos are? So, twice the number. 18 twos are 36. Next to this and in the quotient also, we want to take a number, same number here. So, which ends by 6 in this ends. See the square table here. What are all the possibilities which ends by 6? Here, 4 4s are 16. And one more thing is 6 6 are 36. These two numbers which ends by 6. So, using 4 and 6, we are going to check the answer here. So, 3, 6, 4 into 4 we are going to multiply. 3, 6, 4 into 4. Find the product. 4 4s are 16. 6 remaining is 1. 4 6 are 24. 24 plus 1, 25. 5, remaining is 2. 4 threes are 12. 12 plus 2 is 14. What answer we got now? 1, 4, 5, 6. We got the answer, na? So, we are going to take the number 4 here, and in the quotient also it is 4. 364 into 4 is 1, 4, 5, 6. So, the remainder is 0. Therefore, the square root of 3, 3, 8, 5, 6 equal to the quotient is 184. If you multiply 184 into 184, we will get this 33,856. Is it clear how to find the square root using long division method? One more example we are going to see using this long division method, children. The next sum is 390625. First write the number 390625. What is the first step, children, I told you? Yes, we need to pair the number from the ones digit. So, pair from here. Now, we can find the square root using long division. What is the first pair? 39. See which number we can take here, which is nearest to 39? Yes, 36. What number we can take? 6, 6 are. So, in divisor as well as in the quotient, we need to take 6. 6, 6 are 36. What is the remainder now? Subtract this 39 minus 36. 9 minus 6 is 3. The next step, what do you want to do? We want to take the pair of number. The pair of number is what here? 0, 6. And how to form the new divisor here? Yes, we need to multiply the quotient by 2. Multiply by 2, 6 2s are 12. And here, and next to the 6, we want to take the same number. The product of this 1, 2 and this number should be nearest to what? 306. So, one by one, we will check the number using from 1. 121 into 1 equal to 121. And the next number is 122 into 2 equal to, multiply with this 2. 2 2s are 4. Again, 2 2s are 4. 2 1s are 2. Okay, 123 into 3. 3 3s are 9. 3 2s are 6. 3 1s are 3. See, we need the product nearest to 306. But here it is 369, which is greater than this number. So, we are going to take the previous number, which is 122 into 2. So, we are going to take the new divisor as 2, and in quotient also place 2. So, the product of this is what? 244. 244. Now, for the next step, subtract this. 6 minus 4. What is 6 minus 4? 2. 0 minus 4. Is it possible to subtract 0 minus 4? No. So, you will get borrow from here. It will be 2 and this will become 10. Now, what is 10 minus 4? 10 minus 4 is 6. Take the next pair of number, 2, 5. Now, in the third step also, we want to make a new divisor, right? So, multiply the quotient by 2. 62 is the quotient. So, 62 into 2. 2 2s are 4. 2 6 are 12. So, here the new divisor, I am going to take 1, 2, 4. Next to this number, next to the 4 and in the quotient place also, we want to place the same number now. Okay, this is the last step of the square root, right? So, the last step means we can see the ones number. For 5, what are all the possibilities here? Yes, the number which ends by 5 is 5 5s are. For 5, there is only one possibility with 5. Okay, for other numbers 1, 4, 6, 9, there will be two possibilities for each number. So, for 5, only one number which is 5. If you place 5, surely you will get this 6, 2, 2, 5. We will check the answer. 1, 2, 4, 5 into 5. Find the product of this. 5, 5s are 25.
5, remaining 2. 5 fours are 20. 20 plus 2 is 22, remaining again 2. 5 twos are 10. 10 plus 2 is 12. 2 remaining is 1. 5 ones are 5. 5 plus 1 is 6. So the answer 6,225. We got the answer, right? So the product is 6,225. Therefore, what is the remainder here? It is 0. Finally, we got the answer for the square root of 390625 equal to 625. Is it clear, children, how to find the square root using long division method? So, in this, there is a study material for this questions. Each and every questions, there is an answer for you. Okay, using this study material, you can solve the remaining problems which is given in the exercise. Okay, see, in question bank, only the questions will be given to you for your practice. Okay, after you are finishing this, make use of the self-assessment question paper and evaluate yourself how much you have learned the square root by using long division method, children. Thank you.